WJBW is made possible by sausage. Stick one in your mouth.
I hear a little bit of feedback in the mic.
These charges are not mine.
Today's episode of the Jb WeBB Show is sponsored by Ashtray.
Maybe embellishing.
All right, I'm walking down the street now. I'm walking live here on the street. I'm going to see who I can find.
I need to hear the
Do you want me to do the Jb WeBB Show? Oh, I spit on you.
You are not part of the conversation.
Do you? Do you really?
Thank you for holding, Jb.
I'm listening.
Thank you for holding, Jb.
Definitely a day job I don't complain about.
Gotta find out what's going on, what you're doing, what you're intending to do.
Love Shack, baby!
Juggernaut of rock action.
My baby understands that cigarettes are dangerous. The child reads avidly, backwards, in every language.
WJBW.
You don't want to
The electronics is so predominant that people would really prefer that.
Welcome back. Wow. Welcome back. We have so many people in the studio. WJBWnetworks.com. That's our production. That's our joint. That's what we do. We do every
That's
week.
Where we at.
And we got Jerry Johnson, the Reverend, over
what up,
there.
What up?
Welcome. He's in
what
studio. Up? And a special guest here. Oh, that was not what we said, the clapping.
Yeah,
okay.
Thanks for having me.
Miss Jalicious over there.
Jalicious.
How you doing? And in studio, watching all the pre-show shenanigans, we thought he was going to come later, but he's here early, which is badass.
Awesome.
The one and only legendary Mr. Brian Chodorcoff, and we thank you, sir. We thank you for coming in.
Thank you for having me.
It's awesome. It's awesome. I know we've been talking for a little while about getting you in here, and it was a perfect storm with the event you have coming up out at Will's Pub. I think it's the 18th.
Absolutely.
And
December 18th.
7th annual Jimi Hendrix tribute out there. A lot of great musicians, yourself included, will be out there. It's an exciting event. We're going to talk about that a little bit later. But first, we want to give you the honor, the highest honor that we have here, with exception of local legend supreme, which is gone to Jim Phillips. He's the only one who's received that honor.
Oh.
But local legend is the title that we bestow upon people that have been busting their ass in Orlando and abroad for 20 years, 20 plus years.
Mainly
and,
Orlando, though.
I've been called a lot of things, but
Mainly Orlando.
Now you're legend.
Now
and it doesn't
local
mean,
legend.
It doesn't mean old.
This doesn't go national, buddy. Just kidding.
It doesn't leave this
one
room.
Day,
this room.
It
once
will.
Once we have it all
just today,
set.
we're taking baby steps. But you know, Brian is on.
Yeah.
I mean, he is definitely
well.
A
it's
legend.
Great. I'm happy to have
He's
you.
He's not just local.
What do you say, you guys? You want a little time to get acclimated? You want to hear a little music? I got a little bit of Anthony Cole's Peak Level Indicator side project here.
Anything Anthony?
Is Brian part of that?
Anything Anthony Cole? No. We're going to talk about that in a little bit. Before we kick off the interview, let's get ourselves situated here. Make sure that we're all nice and tight. We appreciate you joining us.
Tight,
it's 407-379-9529. You can call in if you got a question. Try to save that for after 7:30. You can always chat live on Spreaker. There's a whole chat room set up for you. All you got to do is log in and start hitting your keyboards, keys, like their
do
words
it.
And tongues and mouth and teeth and all that great stuff. And we're going to do it, Arnold. Just relax. It's okay.
Yeah.
All right. So let's get a little bit of music and get things straight. And I am JB Webb at Radio JB Webb on the Twit Box.
I'm Jerry Johnson.
And he has.
I'm the Reverend. That's
do you have a Twitter, Jill?
Jalicious.
Did you turn her down?
No, I did not, actually. Oh. She's all the way up. Talk into the mic.
Jalicious underscore TWP.
All right, there you go. That's glorious.
All right.
All right, temporarily on that little mic.
Yeah.
A little bit of a peak level indicator. Again, a side project of Mr. Anthony Cole. Enjoy this. We'll be right back with a local legend interview with the one and only Brian Chodorcoff.
Brian Chodorcoff.
I got
award-winning Bubbaloo's Bodacious Barbecue, Orlando's favorite since 1986. Bubbaloo's Bodacious Barbecue has been recognized by USA Today, The New York Times, and The Food Network. Bubbaloo's Bodacious Barbecue. Get some of this stuff in your face.
Bubbaloo's, Bubbaloo's Bodacious Barbecue is delicious.
Oh, welcome back. It is delicious, Bubbaloo's Barbecue. And when the Orlando Sentinel does the voting, I need you very badly to vote for Bubbaloo's, Bubbaloo's.com. This Word. 2016 is going to be 30 years. They've been wow. That little Lee Road joint with Boo there as our primary sponsor. We thank you so much. And we want to encourage you when that voting starts, which it will soon.
I love going
Orlando
to
Sentinel. Go to Bubbaloo's.
You go there, ask for Lindsay.
Go anywhere else.
Get you the biggest
and then vote Bubbaloo's.
In the jar. They have the best
all the hot pickles there. In the jar. That
the
is
the biggest pickles.
Hey, it's a secret. It
sometimes
is
you have to dig for the biggest one.
Hey, can we stop talking over each other? Because I didn't hear anything either one of you motherfuckers said right now.
You guys are fucking getting worse by the episode.
One person at a time.
Okay.
Always.
Yeah,
that's the rule. That's the rule.
Okay.
I'm done. Go ahead.
Okay. Are you done? Are you sure?
I'm done. Jill? Hey.
Sure?
Let's talk about who we got in the studio right here with us.
Just wait one second. You forgot everything. We are WJBW, the Reverend and Jillicious in studio joining. So there's a little bit of awkwardness, but the cool thing is that we actually have a great guy in studio that's very talented. And I've been talking to him for a long time, for years. Hey, I think it's been years, hasn't it? Like, I've been trying to reach out to you.
I think I was on the road the last time, couple of times, and then just time.
Into the mic a little more, Brian.
Oh, there you go.
There we go.
Sorry, I'm hard of hearing. Right. So
get all
of
it. Oh, okay, perfect. There you go. So we have Mr. Brian Chodorcoff in studio. Thank you. A little later, we're going to talk about the Jimi Hendrix tribute, Will's Pub, December 18th,
food
and
drive.
And there's a food drive for Fern Creek Elementary pantry store or school. You know, their whole pantry there.
I've talked
food
to them.
Pantry.
They fix we're going to talk.
We're going to talk about that a little bit, and then Brian's actually going to plug into the board. I think, and give us a little guitar, which is going to be remarkable.
Dude.
We'll go into breaking news badly, and then probably a little after-hours show, because we're already behind. We get a little behind. It's not so bad.
Always ish.
Just try
ish.
To, yeah, get ish. A little behind. All right, so Shucky, you got it? Okay, he's got it over there. All right, ready?
Hey, Shucky, got it?
Local legend interview with Brian Chodorcoff. I like the New England Chodorcoffs better than the Manhattan Chodorcoffs.
You're an idiot.
So stupid.
Brian Chodorcoff of many famed Orlando bands is in studio with us. We're going to dive deep into his musical origins. We're going to find out about all of his philanthropic efforts he's doing to help young children in local schools. And he does that with music, and he does everything with music, I think. So we're so honored and privileged and very happy to have him in studio, the one and only Mr. Brian Chodorcoff. Buddy, welcome.
Yeah.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah.
It's an honor to be here.
Man, it's an honor to be here in the same room with you as well, Brian. Thanks again for being here.
That's the big thing. That's the big thing. You've been in.
That is a big thing.
I want to think about this. How many bands have you been in? Number one, if you can count them. All right.
That's a very difficult question.
Let's stew on that one, okay? Because the first thing we always like to do with people is find out about their musical origins. Okay. I love to find out if you had inclinations towards music, or you kind of were forced to pick it up. You disciplined yourself to learn it. How did you first get involved?
You want to go back to the womb?
Yeah, I want to go back to. Yeah, did you do? The hippie festival,
grade.
Born at Woodstock.
Wow, that would have been nice.
No, you were. All right, make sure you get all up in that mic, sir. There you go.
Yeah,
I just want
go.
You nice and juicy there.
We want to hear
you.
These stories, Brian. Yes. We want to hear
there
you.
You. There
I'm
you
hard of hearing.
Perfect. There you are.
There it
is. That's crazy.
We're
you're
all hard
like
of
Beethoven.
Hearing.
You're hard of hearing.
Well, I create, unlike Beethoven, I created my hard of hearing.
Well, we'll leave that one alone, but... So peel us all the way back as far as you can go. I mean, as far as your involvement with music, I am fascinated by different people.
Fourth grade.
Really? Okay.
It was
like band?
No, nothing like that. It was, you need to do some things after school, you know? And so I, you want to do
extracurricular?
This? Yeah. And so for about a year, I did it because it was something I did after school.
Okay.
Sixth grade.
guitar exclusively?
Yeah, it was guitar right away. And at about sixth grade, the cassettes started to roll in, you know, rock and roll music.
Yeah.
And then I discovered the penny thing where you get like 11 cassette
tapes. Oh, right.
So my collection.
What was that, Columbia House
or something? And ripping off the Columbia House people began then. can't believe how many times they welcome you back after you don't pay them.
You're able to.
I gave you the penny. But
dog's name.
That was what it was, though. Sixth grade, I started getting into music. The summer of sixth grade to seventh grade, I know probably my folks probably didn't love it, but I up until then had played, you know, every sport. I dropped every sport.
Okay.
Smoking cigarettes, and I was playing guitar 4 hours a day. I was just in love with the thing, and it occupied all my time, to be honest with you. And so, you know, I wasn't getting in trouble. I wasn't doing, like, stupid things yet.
You were just of the trouble.
Where it began.
Okay.
That's really where it started. And then, so the next few years, I always knew. I was lucky enough to have a teacher that I try and be just like him. He's still a mentor. It's, you know, the way that he taught was with life lessons. He was a guidance counselor. He taught me a lot about what playing with feeling really meant, and also what jobs were out there, because what are the odds? What are the odds that somebody's going to pick up a guitar and get out there and go make enough money to pay their bills? Really, so he made it real clear
what
my options were. Not against, because I was in love with all of it. And
I like
this
the way
point,
you put that, dude. That's great. It's not what you're up against; it's what you're might face.
So in saying that, though, I mean, it kind of helped you overcome challenges. You used it as a bonding tool, it sounds like, which is what the aspect of it that I like, where you're able to actually, code emotions and get them out through music.
Then come the next step, playing music with other people.
Okay, that's a good point.
When that happened, it was like, whoa, wait a minute.
So when did that start?
That was like eighth grade.
Okay. You were in like a band. Do you remember your first band name? What are you doing over there, Jerry?
There were these guys that had a thing called Switch. God. Can't believe going this far back. This is amazing. They just played at the school things and whatever. And then I played with them. But then, high school, these kids that were older than me. And this was actually a really important period for me, a week for me, because I was intimidated by these guys because they were older than me. And I could play by then, but I was intimidated by them. And then, so I kind of like probably held back a little bit.
Okay.
And so then the next time the drummer who really knew me was like, man, just be yourself, And so I played, and they turned out they all were kind of looking up to me, even though I was the littlest dude in the room, and I was terrified of them. Now they're treating me with like respect.
Yeah.
Like they were looking up to me. And so that wall of intimidation came down. And in that time, because that guy was talking about my mentor, he even said, you're going to be intimidated. Everybody's better than you, man. Everybody's always going to you got to be a sponge.
Right.
You got to like it.
Right.
Not be scared of it and want to get in there and not run away from it.
Yeah. No bullying, huh?
That's smart. What was the name of the band? Do you remember?
Switch was the eighth
switch.
Grade.
Okay,
they already
right.
existed.
Okay, you told us that. Yeah.
We don't like girls. We're switching.
No,
this car is a switch.
And then there was.
But that was must have
that
been
was experimental 80 phase for him.
Yeah, that's like
just kidding, Brian. You know, kidding.
Okay,
good
all
God.
Right. So, so that kind of started your foray into working with other people. Developing your skills. Knocking down walls of intimidation.
Next best thing that happened was Chris Fiore, rest his soul, bass player, and Mike Perillo was that.
Okay.
We started to just play together and jam. They were the first cats that I ever got together and made up ideas and riffs.
Okay.
And, we'd have a song, we call it the country tune, and all three of us, growing as young players, would use it as an excuse to learn how to play this style. And then they'd be like, Brian, write a metal riff. And I'd come up with two metal riffs, and then we'd, solo and jam over it. And so we just really God, if we had stuck together, we were ahead of the jam scene thing,
right,
you know?
Right,
it was, it was really an amazing thing to have for a year, 2 years in high school. They were older than me, so they graduated, so it was when they came home, you know? But until Chris died, it was every time I went home, we would at least get in someone's basement, if not do a gig.
And what was that band name?
Jam Cake. We opened up Mike's mom's cookbook, and that was the idea, and it went right. Yeah. That was the first page.
Wow. That's a great, great name. Well, you should bring that back.
It's a funny name, but it's like...
It kind of ties in with like JC. Jam Cake. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying?
You know, okay. Not really, but you got Jam Cake, and then you got
that's a quantum.
JC.
Hey, Brian.
I don't know.
Yeah.
It's so awesome to have you here. I'm excited to... we've obviously crossed paths many years.
Yeah, absolutely.
Back in the day.
Trying to figure out the start.
Yeah, we're just like, okay, I was at that party.
Yeah.
I heard you.
I knew all those people, too.
Definitely, you are a local legend, and the way you play guitar and played with many bands. I have a lot to ask you back in the...
she's got a notepad again. That's good. No, I
brought notes.
Just like, I like to ask you, like, being in the Orlando scene for this long, you know, we've seen it grow to where it is to now. Like, what do you think of the changes? How do you think of the scene is turning out?
Right? You know, I love Orlando. I choose to be here. You know, there's other places I could probably work out of and
make more money,
things like that. But I always say, like, it's the people, not the place necessarily, because there's about a million other places I'd like to take all these people, you guys, every single great aspect of Orlando, and move it to some town in North California or Colorado. That'd be great.
Awesome, but definitely.
Since
right?
that can't happen, then here is this intense, the music scene, since I've been involved in it, you know, I got down here and the first cats I met were the Gargamel guys through Full Sail person and you know, so I wound up meeting some of those guys, and, you know, right away, they were the first cats that had a warehouse that had, they were, like, rehearsing every day. Their gear was badass.
Yeah.
They had porn on the wall.
Yeah.
It was awesome. It was rock and roll, and
yeah.
I had never seen it, and so jumped into it, and for about 8 years, I moved away and kept coming back, and then about 97, 98 forward, I've been here. Because the you know, to answer your question, the music scene, it kind of goes in these waves. Right now is a really strong wave, but there's always...
I definitely feel like it could come back a bit. And I also feel like people that stray from Orlando, they still have their heart in Orlando, and I see a lot of them coming back, and there's so much talent that comes out of here, and it's so great to have... like us building it again.
Yeah, there's just a really creative, really incredibly creative, incredibly talented bunch of people that really are playing for, you know what, you know, who am I to judge, but like the right reasons. Like they're
right.
playing
Absolutely.
With their soul, their heart and their soul, and they give a million percent in everything, and it's in all genres of it, and it's small. In fact, a buddy who's playing at Little Indies tonight, Bjorn, a new friend on the road with Kaylee Baker. He stayed at the house the other night. And we're talking about that. It's like the people. You wind up meeting these people, and next thing you know, you're doing something in that town.
And also, do you not think, Brian,
you're shooting at
like,
some food
it comes
and
back
then...
again? How do you feel like the difference is, say, like when you were in my friend Steve, and the band got signed, and then you and Ralph got fired right afterwards.
And then,
well,
and then, and then,
that changed
wait.
With people today looking back, looking at how we really had it.
The order of those events are a little bit different.
Yeah. This question, we're turning your mic down.
You can cut her mic at any moment,
sir.
No,
because
no, it's a great story, how everybody's grown from this.
Right,
it's
but
amazing.
You did the, but you kind of flim flammed them on.
No,
the,
dude,
let
me. I don't, I
oh,
think it's,
right.
I think it's
okay.
A,
before
it's
you answer this
story.
Question,
I think it's a great story.
Okay, listen.
It was a good question.
And Ralph is honored.
Listen,
could have been asked differently.
Ralph is honored, and Steve has come back and realizes none of that happened. Did people feel that the fame got to their heads, And then coming back and realizing what we really had in Orlando was real.
We weren't concerned.
We realized what it was.
Okay.
So wait.
We weren't concerned with any of that.
Please don't stop.
To be honest with you, we were concerned with the music. We weren't thinking about fame. I mean, a little bit. Maybe some people were, but you know, particularly Ralphie and I were thinking about music, and we're excited that here was an opportunity.
Right.
And then when the opportunity changed, you know, like it always does, it actually opened up doors. You know, that's when I eventually put a couple ideas together that were, you know, that's when I put together the JCs, was out of the ashes of that and out of the ashes of, you know, we played with every big pop band in the universe, it seemed like, current and old. And, you know, having that experience in my 20s, that was great. Going on to, you know, starting the JCs, that never would have happened had I stuck in the pop band that I wasn't really that into.
Not to disrespect Steve, I love Steve's writing.
Yeah.
He is, absolutely, no disrespect.
But it was on a different trajectory because of the path, and it made you everything. Because of what was coming out of Orlando at the time, it was on a particular trajectory.
Man, it was a pop scene, and pop bands were coming out.
Right, you got Matchbox 20, you've got, you know, a number of different, yeah, the Creed
as
thing.
As well as I think so, it's coming back to a different type of soul, and people have realized...
Appreciate live
really
music.
We really have had it this whole time, and it's gotten better. Honestly,
all right.
It's gotten better.
Okay, well,
it's gotten a lot better.
It's certainly grown.
And we all know this, though, Jill.
It's amazing.
You ask the question, then you dump the praise, so I guess that still counts.
It's always a praise. She's trying to make our guest feel comfortable here.
Let's talk about this for a moment.
We'll save that for after show.
Okay, there's no after show.
Okay.
And no, you don't have to take your headphones off.
Still
you don't have
to
flick
to
me off.
Oh,
come here, put your headphones on.
Okay.
And listen.
All right, Jerry, hold on. The continuity of the interview is being compromised. So let's.
Indeed,
let's,
it is.
Let's focus.
Okay, I'm Barbara Walsh. Let's cut her mic. Can you cut? I'm going to cut that. Can I get you to cry?
Hold on. Okay. So, Brian, here's the point. You've been cut down. Hold on. Just relax. Here's the point. The interesting thing is, again, we kind of jumped.
Look out.
We kind of jumped, you know, a little bit into that. But that, again, I guess it shows your musical ability. And, you know, Orlando back then, before that whole opportunity, and what was that, 96, 7, 95, 6,
yep.
7, something like that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Late 90s.
Yeah, downtown jazz and blues. Now, here's a question I have, because an old-time friend of mine who I haven't seen in a long time actually, I think, brought me over to your house or someone's house or something. It was a party. We're all
there.
Do you remember Ann Ryman?
I absolutely
remember. Okay.
Ann.
Well, that's where I first met you a long time ago, and didn't really, you know, it never
Anthony.
Stuck. This was all, yeah, exactly. We went to this party, and we were all hanging out. And it was Matt Lapham was there.
That
I think
was
I forget who else. Dave
ago.
And Steve, I think, were there. It was a long time
I
ago.
Was there.
It was. No, you weren't. Right. And hold on there. Jillo. There's always room for Jillo.
Yeah, we're
going
to go from
Jillicious
to Jillo.
Yeah. Well,
Jill Solo, we can't hear her.
Okay, now there goes Jerry.
I'm just kidding.
See you. All right, so the point of all that is just simply that, you know, I've known about your skills and talents and kind of, you know, really admired what you've done. So to give you this local legend, you're very welcome. To give you this local legend kind of a title is important to me because, you know, I can remember 20 years ago. So moving ahead, okay, so moving ahead, we're talking about something that's, is his microphone gone? What are you talking
about? No, it's still here.
Oh, no, the people that are able
moments.
To, just hold on. I want to move this into open questions for everybody. You can call us in a little bit here, but I want to move this over into kind of how you said, hey, this is Orlando, and I want to grow here, and I want to kind of put down roots or what have you, and... the point, though, is simply that. Where did the nurturing of the community come from? The music community. Where did all of that come from?
You know, there was obviously stuff going on before I got here. But when I got here, there was a very small scene, a very small place, amount of places, especially for original musicians. And that... feel, you know, honored and lucky to be a part. I remember, you know, and there's a lot to do that when Wills didn't have a stage and they'd bring, you know, they put people on the pool table on flatboards, and you know, so to see that the love and the
growth,
like it actually, like it started to gain some respect, and then all of a sudden we were in bands that started to bring people in, and then we were able to do things like benefits to raise money for people that needed help, and then the community really weaved itself, and there's a lot of people, they all know each other. It's a tiny community.
Well, that's what I'm saying. The whole thing about, you know, again, I think I've witnessed you was at Will's Pub when it was Lock Haven. And that's what I want to say before all that. That's what it's an empty room and a PA, right? That was kind of how it all started. Empty room and a damn PA. But anyway,
even a PA. You had to bring that for sure.
Well, and flash forward to Will's Lock Haven Pub, right? There was a kid there doing Jimi Hendrix, and he was incredible. And I forget what night it was or how I got to go. I heard about it from one of my friends, but I went there. Is that Machado? Yeah.
It is.
That's the same guy?
Let him explain.
Here's the thing with Marcus.
Great story.
Right? The first thing, you know, it was like all of a sudden you had opportunities in this town where people like me with an idea and a friend like Will were able to like execute things and do things. And it was really cool to be one of many people that were starting to do things because we had this home, you know. And I put together this Jimi Hendrix tribute because whether you know it or not, if you're in a rock band, you own something or other.
Yeah, definitely.
And so I put it together, and there's all these great bands like Cow and, you know, a bunch of bands, Clues, in the day that were really big bands. The place was packed. It was in
huge.
The front room. There's 200 people. It's completely packed to where it's hard to get a drink, and in walks this, like, 10 or 11-year-old boy, his little sister, his mom and dad, and, you know, kind of tugs on me. I heard you're the show guy.
Right.
Can I play a song?
Right.
And
come on, man,
you know, I teach.
It's all Joseph Martin and you.
I teach and I play. You know, I play guitar in bands and I teach to make ends meet. And so, looking at this little kid, the way he looked at me, it was like, oh, shit, man, this bill is filled.
Yeah.
All these guys worked really hard.
Did you know?
Get up there, man.
Did you know he could play?
Okay. No idea. So he gets up there. And he starts out with the Star Spangled Banner. And then all of us, all the bands, everybody's like, let this kid play, man. Let him play. And so Marcus played for a half hour, 45 minutes.
I remember that.
And then I had to get everybody else up on the bill and on the stage. And so, you know, we became friends with Marcus and all that. But then he grew up and he moved away. And now he's in Europe somewhere, really killing it. And he's in Brooklyn right now, and he just won a Rolling Stone magazine award for the next young gun guitarist.
Awesome.
And he just played an album release at the Blue Note.
Okay.
He's really killing it, and he's grown up now. And so, like, we've kept in touch because he calls me Big Bro. He calls you know, I knew he was coming home to visit. I was like, dude, come play the show, man. Play with Ant. So
amazing.
Anthony Cole and a guy, Dave, I'm sorry, I can't remember your last name because I just met you, but you're going to play bass and myself too with you. And
it's gonna be awesome.
Marcus coming home. That's the story of Marcus. He went out in the world, and I see these pictures of him in Europe.
Didn't
he's
he
playing
get some
to 10,000
Rolling
people.
Stone fame?
He just
best.
Told you that.
Yeah.
He just told you that in the story.
Yeah. He won the award.
Yeah. So he definitely won the award for that.
And to have him, man, is insane because now he's all grown up with the world. You know, there's a thing when you're a kid who can play guitar, it's like when you bend a note, it doesn't have that feel, that meaning, you know. Now when you grow up and you understand what that bend is, that moan, that hurt or that happiness, whatever it's really giving you, Marcus has that under his belt too. So I can't wait to hear him.
So let me ask you this, Brian, because I know what you're doing today. I mean, not only are you performing, you know, all the time at some of the best venues and some of the best performances, but you're also teaching the children today. And you, like you said just a moment ago, how you saw this kid tugging on you. And is this kind of what inspired you to teach kids today? Because I know you are amazing.
I was already teaching by then. But
were you already doing that by then?
I was teaching...
Oh, that's
real little kids when I was in high school.
Okay.
Like, at the music store down the street from the high school. But then, so I guess that's where it started, you know?
Right.
But as I got older and life and, I, you know, you need to make money.
Yeah.
I wound up in a situation where, again, another chapter, I wound up working at Dr. Music. Ralph Amadori, Jack Sterling,
wow.
Kevin Stevers,
wow.
All these people worked there, you know, Doc.
That's how you guys were kind of making ends meet,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, so I meet these guys, and I'm teaching, and then long story short, I leave that that place, and I started home teaching, giving less driving to people's houses like my teacher.
Right.
And I love it. If I was a millionaire, I would still teach. If I was a billionaire, I would still teach.
That's
I might
awesome.
Show up in a helicopter buzz, but I will be there because like being all I am is a light for a room. I give you the chords, Beethoven, Metallica, the Beatles. It's the same E chord. It's
right.
how you want to paint the room. So I'm supposed to do that. So
wow.
Definitely, I wanted to ask you real
That's
quick.
Awesome, man. That is awesome.
Your musical influences growing up.
Wow.
Let me ask you, like Clapton, Jimmy Page.
Yeah, you're
tell
on
me
the.
About, tell me about like Jeff Beck.
You're right on the money. I was definitely those three. You know, they were like the classic guitar heroes still, and I definitely became a school of that. And you know, it was because of those guys and those records that got into blues and soul music because they were covering that occasionally. You know, you look on a Led Zeppelin record and you see. Willie Dixon's name, like, who's that
right.
guy?
Yeah.
You know? Fast forward many years later, my wife, who's now my wife, we did
Brittany.
A show called
I love
20th Century... me too.
Yeah,
20th Century...
oh, yeah.
Early Blues, 20th Century, a big show for it, and she painted, like, 50... sketch with charcoal, actually, sorry. 50 of these blues cats, and Terry Binion... Jeff Schumar, Jim O'Rourke, maybe Thomas might have been on it. I don't even remember at this point.
Right.
But everybody came and played deep blues. It was amazing.
It's awesome.
Nice. That is
that's
awesome.
Cool.
So it was like
that's 70s, a glorious thing.
Class 60s and 70s, like just classic rock.
Is that,
yeah.
Is
well,
that really what like you, that was your ear? And did you try and mimic what you were hearing?
Talk into the.
Or did you? You know, they were. Is that what inspired
well,
what, you?
Probably one of the best things that'll happen to any player is when you can play with your ear. And play what you're listening to. And, you know, that when I was like a pretty young teenager was able to do was to jam along with records and learn parts sometimes.
Right.
And sometimes just pretend you're the fifth Beatle. You're making up a melody, but it works.
So
you're not allowed in the dressing room. You're not allowed. You can't eat the deli platter. You can't drink a beer, but you're the fifth one.
But definitely.
So wait,
that,
wait, wait.
That probably had to make you have visions of when you did play with other people. And help you feel more confident getting on stage with others. And you just feel like, okay,
over to
I'm
Jerry.
Gonna get Eric Clapton in here. Yeah,
Jerry's got his hand raised.
Well, every now and again, you know. You don't, yeah, again, you don't really necessarily think about too much who you're kind of ripping off or
so let me ask
quoting, you,
this. You
know.
What were you thinking about?
Right.
What were you thinking about when you actually did get to go up on stage with one of your true guitar legend idols? And by that, I mean, you know, I know for a fact that you were up with B.B. King.
Wow.
Well, when you say share a stage, I didn't play with them, but I've opened for some serious legends. And
well, yeah, I was going to say that that's the big thing is that we Sam Rivers, you know, from here, I know you've, you know, worked
absolutely.
In that
right.
whole
yes.
Area very well.
Totally.
And so
rest
I guess
it, beautiful
to
soul.
Keep
he
as much continuity as we can as far as moving along into, you know, your musical history, I appreciate that insight. But let's kind of take a little bit of that and then kind of flip and talk a little about the night out at Will's, December 18th. We're speaking with the local legend himself, Brian Chodorcoff of
many, a big flip-flop.
Various, many various Orlando bands, legendary JC.
Definitely.
He's played with Sam Rivers, right? We've got a little by my friend Steve. We've got
you
a little.
Never
so.
A stage?
Sam, I didn't really play with Sam, but Sam joined the JCs a few times.
Okay.
Okay.
Sam was BB's band leader, and when we met and played, when we played with BB King, Sam came and played with us, and he went on BB's bus, and the BB got in, you know, not in trouble. He couldn't get in trouble, but he was on the bus for too long while the band's, you know, vamping a chord waiting for him to come out, and he's up there chatting with Sam Rivers. And I had already said to Sam, I don't want to be corny, man, but if there's any way I can get a picture, and BB walked off the, I'll never forget, he steps off the bus, points at me. he looks at Sam like, is this the guy? Points at me, points where I'm supposed to stand, stands next to me, and Dave Siegel from Bootleg Television snapped the picture. Captured Eugene's it. In one of them, yeah. And the other one, Gene's walking. He's behind Sam walking. It's really funny.
I've seen these pictures that you talk of, and that's why I was bringing it up. Like, Dave Siegel, he's awesome at catching these awesome moments. And
incredible archive.
Yes, and... It's nice to have you in the studio with us, Brian, for sure. I mean, when we talk about local legend, I mean, you're more than a local. I mean, you are just, you're a legend. The people you've worked with and
are way too kind.
Well, I'm not trying to be kind. I'm just trying to speak the truth.
They
Brian.
Stopped. Oh, they stopped. They're like awesome. Awesome. Totally awesome. No, that's and I agree. You know, we do tend to fawn over the guests here because that's again our style. We want to make people realize how great Orlando is. And sometimes when you're too far away from something or too close to something, you don't see it right. So when you get the right perspective, you can kind of get a little bit deeper, and I appreciate you coming in here. You're a great guy. You're a personality, and we have a little bit of music that we
there
can
we
cut,
go. Let's
we
take a little break.
Away to. Is that what
and
you
want
to
really
do?
Want
is
hear
is
you
that
play
the consensus?
Let's take a little break, please.
Everyone wants to take a break.
Everyone wants a break.
Everyone wants
a break.
Okay. Well, we'll be back. All right, then we'll be back with a continued conversation with Mr. Brian Chodorcoff about. We're going to flip over into. We're going to flip over into. And talk about the Jimi Hendrix tribute. It's
Definitely.
The 7th annual event, December 18th out there, and Food Drive. Thank you very much. And that's, I had a question about that. Can people bring 20 cans of food and get, like, what is it? What would that be?
No, that's the funny thing. You don't get the discount
drinks.
That way.
Can you get, like, a drink poster combo if
poster.
You bring 8?
Close to anything I do is attached to helping Fern Creek Elementary School because... Mm-hmm. It's right in the neighborhoods I've lived for since I've been here on and off and it's still in. And when I found out that the kids are bussed in from Pine Hills and other places and they're hungry.
Yeah.
And they're not eating 3 meals a day and they're not like they're like somehow just really struck a nerve that like we're right down the block. Will's is right down the block and what can we do?
Right.
Come into Will's, kids.
Yep. No.
Pop a stool.
Not what he's saying. He's saying
belly up to the bar, kids. We're going to teach you nice.
They're doing canned. They're accepting canned
donations.
You
know, it started
donations.
With I called Will and said, man,
get these kids out of here.
I'll buy a case of PBR, man. If somebody comes in and gives you a can of food, will you... give him a PBR.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm,
and
mm-hmm.
So he said, well, maybe. And then he came up with a much better idea.
Yeah.
Long story short, we came up with the Fern Creek Food Pantry, Fern
Fun
Creek
Drive.
Elementary Wait. School Food Pantry Program.
Oh, my goodness.
That's what they call
That's
it.
That's a great.
I need
I
to work on that
it
shit.
Shoo.
Come up with the acronym. What is it?
I
food
just
Pantry.
Shoo.
Okay.
Shoo.
Okay. Shoo.
So now almost everything I do has that. You know, any like bigger shows, I guess. We just had the Bob Dylan. Like, it's always
you add.
So
to
you
it.
Get a either a drink ticket or a which is probably like a shitty beer.
Is
or,
it a badass laminated poster you gave me?
It's the same
I want
poster,
you to sign
not
it.
Laminated.
Oh, okay. Wait, can you sign a laminated poster?
I think so.
We'll figure out the physics. I got a Sharpie over there. All right. Well, anyway.
I got something for you to autograph.
I appreciate. All right, Jill, I'm going to turn you back down. No, I'm just kidding. So I appreciate you being here, Brian. Hang
thank
tight.
You guys.
Thank you so much. We're going to come back and talk about this event. We've been speaking with a freshly dubbed local legend, Mr. Brian Chodorcoff. We're going to give you a little bit of Last Electric Rodeo and then pop on. On back, right? Is that what we're doing?
Yeah,
okay.
We're gonna pop on back.
Okay,
talk, and we're gonna hear some music from Brian.
Thanks for. Oh yeah, and then we're
looking
gonna plug
forward
it.
To that.
We're gonna plug it in. He's gonna plug in. I think.
Plug it in.
What kind of cables?
Plug it in.
We
plug
need to know
in.
What cables you have. Let's root
what
that out during
you
this
got?
Break.
That's what she said.
Okay, enjoy this song. We'll be right back, or you will.
Beautiful bouquet. The number you have dialed has been changed. The new number is... Please note, the new number is...
Roam the rusty track with the baby sack. County ties lead to nowhere. Time and purpose vanish in the air. Motivation lag from a quarter.
People would really prefer that.
My crib, my car, my fancy things, my
whack ass bling,
my Bentley, my Porsche, my accumulated scratch, my Range Rover, boom boom.
Ow!
Gimme my champagne, my
fashion designer clothes, Gucci this, Fendi that.
Woo! Gimme that, my
Louis V sweaters
with the hat to match, my Boeing jet, my
paradise life,
my yacht got a triple deck.
Woo!
My clothes, my jewels, my
money in the bank.
Bill Gates, Donald Trump, let me in. My money,
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 my cash, my
dough,
my riches,
cheddar,
bread,
dollars, my
gold,
my
diamond rolls,
beamer,
Lexus,
my chromed out semis, $2,000 and pop.
This is why, this is why, this is why I'm hot. My pool, my VIP, my wood decorated on chrome,
candy coated Chevy,
my fine wine Bacardi,
Ben Frankie,
big money,
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 top dollars,
cheddar,
money,
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 and a white man get paid off for all of that.
WJBW, Orlando, Florida, the first quasi-radio web show.
Wow.
Yeah, hey.
All right, all right. Welcome back. Welcome back, JB Webb, here in studio with Mr. Brian Chodorcoff, the Reverend over there.
Yeah.
And Miss Jillicious, thank you for joining us.
Here I am. Back again,
Oh, what are you speaking of?
I said, speaking of legends.
What are you guys cooking up over there? You guys were doing something, cooking up something. All right, well, we're going to. He's
cooking up some trouble.
Brian's got his guitar.
Don't blow out our meth project.
Don't tell me what to do.
Cooking up some trouble.
It's on my muscle.
Yeah.
Here you go. He's got his guitar out. But we're going to talk a little about the Jimi Hendrix tribute. You, seventh year in a row. It's grown organically.
Not in a row. It's
in a row?
97.
Seventh.
98, 99.
Okay. Oh, 90. Then, I didn't know it started all the way back then.
Yeah.
Wow.
And then when did we pick up again? Just a few years ago.
Yeah, it seems like the last several years it's been consecutive.
It's been three. This is the third year.
Okay.
And yeah, absolutely. There's been three since we picked it up again, and it's, you know, it's like it's may not go forever. You know, I'm not by any means like the biggest Jimmy, you know, person in the universe.
Right.
You know, it was something that
you're fostering it,
and it's very it is very important to me. You know, I don't want anyone to accuse me of not being the right cat
authentic,
for it. You know,
I
truly love Jimmy, and I think that honoring him sort of is like this little kind of ticket to like, yeah, man, thanks for that stuff that you gave us.
Yeah.
You know, it's like, here's a way. And also, I'll be honest with you, it's now my secret way to get all the people that I love in the same room,
I love that.
At that time of year.
It's no longer a secret.
It's an excuse to throw a Christmas party.
That's
and
awesome.
More important than anything is that it does raise money for those kids at Fern Creek who need it.
Yeah, and you can bring canned good donations.
And, you get a free poster or drink, like beer ticket after three or four cans, you know?
And let's talk about that poster for a minute, because the poster, I don't know if you haven't seen it, it's on Facebook, and it was done by a mutual friend of ours.
Mm-hmm. Benjamin Ensfelder.
Yeah, and who is a most amazing talented artist.
Was in a
artist.
Band around here called Bathhouse Secrets many years ago.
I think Jerry knows about that.
Of course, and that's why I'm bringing this up. But if you look at the poster, which is right there in front of us, which Brian actually brought a laminated one in for you.
And I'm keeping it. You took my Jessica Pauly poster, by the way.
So in any event, the poster alone, I mean, it's just there's so much talent that's going to be
I'll be honest with you, man. Ben is a part of a long line now.
Yeah.
Scramble was one of the artists.
Dalla. Brett.
No, my wife and Scramble.
Definitely your wife.
Two years ago, she did a bunch of posters for it, the event, the main poster for it. And hi, baby, if you're listening.
Oh, Brittany.
Hi, Brittany.
Brittany's awesome. And her artwork is amazing as well.
Which hangs and is for sale in the Smiling Bison. Anything that is music related.
Love that. Second week in a row, Smiling Bison has come up.
That's right.
They're a great place.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Played there Saturday.
Definitely want her to hang her stuff at Twist Hair Studio.
Oh, another opportunity.
Yes,
there you
yes,
go.
Yes, we love that we hang local artists. So
Edgewater. She's off of Edgewater.
Okay.
Yeah. So Kristen, if you are listening, you got to call me.
It's not Kristen. Her name's Brittany.
Oh, my God.
So. Brittany, anyways,
if you're answering to Kristen today, listen to Janet when she tells. All right,
so,
what were you doing? Where were we going with all this?
We were going.
Bring canned goods. That's what
bring canned goods. That's what it's really about. Is bring canned goods to the event. And you know what? The truth is, like anything, like Will has been so gracious and important to it too, to get everybody.
Kind of rally around it.
You know, last year we did a thing called Classic Country Covers, and you know we weren't really bragging about it too much, but Will was donating a lot of money, and that money was coming from beer sponsors
and
himself as well.
Yeah,
coming right out of his pocket.
We were able to give Fern Creek some you know cold hard cash and a check. That worked, you know. And,
a check that worked.
And,
a check
and,
that
you know,
cleared.
I'm regularly, because of, you know, the Bison does it and Wills does it.
Okay.
That's
fantastic.
Brings the cans. And sometimes it's like, you know, shopping carts full. Last year's Hendrix thing, it was ridiculous how much food. And,
yeah.
And that every note worth all of that, you know.
So, yeah, and this is a glorious cause, and that's also, too, why I said, hey, let's get in here and not only do the local legend interview, but also talk about this great event that you're doing that is, again, the fuel behind why we want to do the local legend interview. You know, it is basically Orlando's indie kind of forefathers being real philanthropic and doing the best they can to, you know, support the local community, a real establishment, a school for kids,
you know?
A public school.
You nailed something there, man. The reason that I stay here is, you know, partially that we stay here is that, you know, that when something bad happens, the town comes together.
Right.
Or when something needs something, the town comes together. And
right.
I've never been a part of, let alone seen anything like it, really. And it's pretty an amazing thing to be a part of, to be able to raise money for people who need it, you know, to be able to know that food was important, you know. That's
no doubt it is
important.
It
and
warms
that's a thing
your
that
it warms
Orlando.
Our hearts, definitely.
Yeah,
yeah. I mean, we got to help.
Yep.
So
and Orlando does that so beautifully.
We definitely
do.
At the end of the day, we all come together.
Well, here's an interesting thing too, because I had a Facebook post that kind of corroborated. You know, Orlando's music community is real strong, but the art community, I think, is going through some stuff. I think they're going through puberty or something. I'm not sure, but that's without question, because Orlando is a great mecca for artists, musicians, creative people to come. And I encourage every one of you to go out to this event. Now you're going to see Mr. Anthony Cole, Mr. Bobby Koelble, right? Jeff Nolan, okay? And who else? Give me the other players.
Simmons,
Roland
Machado,
Simmons.
Machado, myself.
Marcus Machado, who we just heard the story about.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay.
And James Kilgallen, who is Jimmy Kills. And,
okay.
James was another, like, from Deland child prodigy mm-hmm. kid. He's now in his 20s, so, you know, fancy guitar playing don't mean that much in your 20s, but he's an amazing writer, amazing player, and it's really beautiful to have him on the bill, too, because he's been playing around here since he's, you know, 10 also, and he's, you know, a ridiculously good player. And so James now growing up a lot, too, being on the bill, I'm really excited this year because there's... You know, Marcus and James representing the youth growing up and then the veterans, you know.
Yeah.
Last year, you know, Nolan playing
glorious.
The guitars on the floor. He's playing it with a beer can. I mean, it's glorious, you know. And then Bobby gets up there and, you know, Jim, you could feel Jimi Hendrix like, man, that's what it's supposed to sound
absolutely.
Like.
Absolutely.
My friend Perigo
so are you.
Does a great Jimi Hendrix tribute. He did it at Orlando Calling, but at the end he lights it on fire. So he paints him live and then lights it on fire.
Oh, we need to see some
I
fire
introduce,
and some sparklers.
Introduce you to that guy.
So maybe we get some
well, there's
some
also
sparklers
a surprise
on their guitar.
In the middle. Hopefully there'll be sparklers because that always, you know, well, always helps. But there'll be a Star Spangled Banner rendition.
Okay. Yeah. Stop distracting.
Yeah. Stop distracting him,
Jerry.
I'm just. I have to take a.
Uh-huh.
A break here
I don't
in
know what that means.
5 minutes.
Okay. Well, we're going to play a song.
Will,
we're going to get him plugged in.
Yeah, that's what
we're
going to do.
We're
so we're
going to
play. Now listen.
Let me talk.
Let me talk here.
Let you talk.
I'm going to play.
Let you talk.
We came out of some Pilot Wave before that. Last Electric Rodeo. And then now we're going to go back into some more Pilot Wave, and we're playing them because they're actually at Will's on Thursday night. So Pilot Wave, Berto, a few other great bands are out there. That's Thursday night, Will's Pub. So again, we're speaking with Brian Chodorcoff, and we're going to let him plug into the board here, and we're going to get some fresh electric guitar music mode. And then you need more than 4 or 5 minutes, or how much do you need?
No, that's all we need.
Okay.
Yeah.
Jerry just needs a.
So the point of all that was
Jerry doesn't need long at all. He doesn't need long at all.
Okay.
If you want me to produce the show right,
he doesn't need long.
All right. You know what I'm saying?
That's what she said.
We'll be right back. 16 tons of toxic waste fell down on her from outer space. Now she glows like a radar moon. She'll live forever, I'll be dead soon.
Capable hands of Mr. Brian Chodorcoff. You want the audio mic on? You want to talk or say anything about what you're going to play?
Hold on. I'm just going to play a little bit of Little Wing in in light of what's going on December 18th, the food drive. That is the event that got it got me here tonight, and so it's the biggest thing that I can stress is food drive.
Yeah.
I sound like
bring
a broken
it,
record,
it,
but
it,
I always
it, bring
want
it, bring
that
it, bring
to
it,
be.
Bring it. Hold on. Exactly the point. You bring four cans, you get a drink, you get a beer,
either this year. And again, all the artists, my beautiful wife, Brittany's former posters, Scrambles, former posters, yeah. Ben Ensfelder, who really should talk about Ben. He's a real brilliant artist.
Great
based
work,
out of New York now, from here. And the original's for sale. You got a private message him out there in Facebook land, I'll play a little bit of Little Wing for
you. Okay, all right, cool.
So it's just going to be a sample of cut down
on the mics. Give us a little bit of what you got. This is Mr. Brian Chodorcoff on WJBW Networks. We appreciate it. remarkable. Remarkable.
Brian. Amazing.
Yeah, that was fantastic. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for that. That was remarkable.
Such beautiful music.
Okay, there you go. One,
that,
two.
Yeah,
one
that would
two.
Be great if I could one tell you that,
okay,
Brian.
Three, four.
God.
Hold on.
That was great,
I have all
Brian.
These channels I need to monitor. Hold on, buddy.
So, yeah.
Oh, so he's got the guitar going. Yeah, that's great.
Yeah, we'll just keep it here now.
That's beautiful. Hey. That's beautiful. I love it.
Song.
So, sure? Yeah, so he could do a little song a little later. He could do whatever he wants.
You sure you
want to
take a little break?
He's got total free reign. And we'll go to the end of the show. You know, we'll do whatever you want.
Whatever you want to do.
You can do whatever you want to do.
If you want to call and endorse like Brian, you want to call and ask us
a question about
you can
how,
do that. It's 407-379-9529. We're going
to
open up everything, the phone lines. The text line has been open. It is 407-906-9328, so you can always text us if you'd like to text us something and you're shy to talk on the telephone and you're too afraid to talk on the telephone. You're a little shy and you want to text us.
Yeah.
You can do that, baby. You can do
you
it.
You want to text.
Right. You can do
you
it.
Put that shit in there.
So
you push those buttons.
So with everything
letters.
Going on, right? This event, it's incredible to see, you know, how the community comes together. And like, you know, he was saying that Brian was saying that there's, you know, a certain element of this. Everybody works together. You know, everybody works together and makes it happen. And everybody kind
of,
you know, and the
there's
Ralph
a lot
Fest,
of people involved.
Well,
the
Ralph Fest thing is a beautiful example. That's like
100%.
The number one top example of that.
Yeah. Cheers to Jeff Sweat, the organizer
exactly.
and promoter of that, because
absolutely.
It is, you know, he pulled that together so brilliantly at such an impossibly, insanely impossible, difficult time to even express. You know,
right?
It's always emotional.
I've been in bands with Ralph for 15 plus years, and on the road with him for at least a decade of that. And
wow,
you know, he's a brother,
and
so,
always will be. And what a great way to honor him.
Well, the Ralph Fests are you know, he was about music and a good time, and
absolutely.
he was one of the most beautiful people you'll ever know. And those Ralph Fests are a testament to that. For
and
sure.
And he'd be right here with us today.
Indeed it is. Brian,
so
he'd be making fun of me for doing a Hendrix tribute.
See, I told you. You gotta know your audience,
always
Jerry.
Have your
oh, yeah. He would be, yeah. He'd
that
be.
Respect.
Like I said, he'd be making fun of me too. Like I said a long time ago. Anyway, point being.
We could poke fun at him.
What is
the
point?
Event?
Yeah.
It's December 18th, right? It's out
December
at Will's Pub, okay?
Will's.
And it's a Jimi Hendrix tribute. You will not be disappointed.
Here's a big thing too, man. WJBMF is right next door, and he's doing a '60s rock inspired set. And I don't know if you've ever heard this guy spin. He was at, you know, I'm biased because he was at our wedding, but he's brilliant. He's the life of whatever room
he's in.
He's,
so, wow.
Yeah,
that's two amazing.
He really is. When BMF
right
goes on,
so he'll be at Indies on December 18th also.
Oh, wow.
Because hopefully it'll be busy. You know, I hope everybody comes out.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah, yeah. I'm sure it will.
It'll definitely
be
a busy night.
So
turn her up. Don't let her think she's talking and she's not. Okay.
Well,
it's,
you know,
there you go.
We need
everybody's mic up.
You're definitely talking.
You were cut off there. You were cut off. He cut you off. She's angry at you.
Oh, there she goes.
Okay. All right.
She left
right.
again.
Hold on. Don't come. Just come back. Just relax.
Yeah.
Hold on. Just relax. So hold on.
Everybody's
all relax, right. Relax.
Everybody's
all right. All right. So she's... we are hanging out in studio. We're going to do a little bit of a breakaway. Should I break away? Do you think?
Yeah,
we're going to come back
let's
and
breakaway.
Do some breakaway. You want to hang out and do the news with us with the guitar? Yeah. He's going to do it. Oh,
yeah.
Brian's going to do
here.
It. All right. Cool. So let's do
for
that.
Sure.
Let's talk about this. Let's talk about ShannonHoltArt.com. Go to ShannonHoltArt.com. She is available for awesome exclusive events like body painting, you know, and different things that go along with those events. So, you know, she can paint sequence. You know, it's so beautiful.
Yeah.
ShannonHoltArtwork.com. Go to
ShannonHoltArt.com.
Go there. Check out that website. StreetJelly.com. If you play music and you play online and you play with... Hold on, Jerry. I got a solution for you, but I got to break away.
All right.
Hold on, buddy.
Hey.
If you play music, streetjelly.com, you can go online.
That's where
minimal
to go.
Hardware, right? And set up audio, video,
and make money.
Go into a community and they do online busking. Exactly. So they do online busking. That's right. Yeah. You can play your music on the internet highway.
Just like
baby.
Brian's doing right
Just
now.
Just like those blues right there.
That's right. That's right. Awesome.
So, what was I doing? Oh, so I got to find a song, but I'm talking about sponsors.
Let's talk about some sponsors for a minute, like ArtArmy.org. ArtArmy.org is a big sponsor and a big part of this, and we appreciate everything they do for us. There's no doubt, you know. So it's really nice to have everyone here in the studio tonight. Delicious. Even though she's mad. Your mic's on. Your mic's on.
Your mic's on?
Oh, okay.
Okay, there
it's
you
on.
Go.
And the other big sponsor of Twist Hair Studio.
Twist Hairs. There we go.
Get your appointment booked now for the holidays. Make sure you look good because.
There we go.
Got to see that family.
And that's Twist.
Time to get out that Yule time cheer.
Delicious.
Get your hair done.
Do you got a Twitter account?
Delicious _ TWP.
Nice. And what's your website? I mean, we all know you're on Facebook.
TwistHairStudio.com.
There we go.
You can look me up. You can look me up on Instagram. Jill Hardy. Right. Delicious.
Yeah, you
want to
write us a theme song.
Delicious. We love that you're here, by the way. We do.
And I enjoy being here, too.
I know. I really enjoy
being here. We're
going
to put a little twist on this.
There you go. That's what we need. So,
you always need a girl in here to...
Here and there. You know,
to balance it out, a little twist it up.
Exactly.
Have a little fun.
We are having fun, are we not?
Down.
Oh, great time. We're having a good time.
All right. So, twist here, studio.com. All right.
What did you do last
Delicious.
Night?
Delicious.
What did you do last night?
What?
What'd you do? Hey, this isn't good for my business. This is bad for business.
It's like the nature of
what? Yeah. We'll be right back.
Yeah, I'll take the blame. I will take the blame.
You ain't got no shame.
And now.
Really, no more?
Breaking Why? News badly.
How is that? It adds a lot.
I can give you my board.
Shame, shame, you got no game.
Why is it my board?
Let's play it, all the shame.
Okay, there you go.
All right.
Just
well, there we go.
Slowly pull that out. All right, welcome back.
That's what she
WJBW. Said. WJBW, we're doing a little breaking news badly. We still have our in-studio guests, so this could go this
song?
Could go many different
do you
ways.
Need a theme song?
I would love a theme song, of course. I'm not going to pass down a theme song. What are you talking about? All right, but if we're going to do it, then I got to do a studio.
That.
Okay, oh, he's
do
back. Oh,
there we go.
God,
see? See what that this adds to your breaking news badly?
Here we go. It's our new theme song, guys.
No. Let him think about
you
what
feeling
it is.
Together,
you're
the three of
too.
Us together.
I don't want it in the moment.
There's four of us here,
three,
by the way.
No, but we're the three best friends that anyone could have.
What about?
I like where your head's at.
All right, let's maybe.
I like where my head's at.
But it's. All right.
Oh, see that?
Let him do what he wants to do. How about that?
Let's all. Let's
all do what we want to do.
As long as we all do it one at a time, besides the musical background, it'll be perfect.
You're about to do the news, right? Typewriter?
Can I be in the middle?
Thank you. Typewriter.
Do it.
Come on.
The Jesus and Mary Chain start work on their first new album in 17 years. Thank you.
No, Jesus you like and the Mary Chain. I do like Jesus and the Mary Chain.
12th Street Beat.
I do.
.wordpress.com. There you go. It's a blog.
Wait, Brian.
So it could be totally fake.
Are you familiar with Jesus and the Mary Chain?
Really a name only.
Well, they are an old school 80s band.
80s pop,
alternative.
Definitely.
Who
is it that English whiny voice?
Kind of, yeah. That's, there you go. So you do know the band.
That's why I avoid
you know it. All right. So continue on there, JB, with this breaking news battery.
Oh, but I'm sure the record's great. The record's
coming
out.
Oh, it's
going
to be awesome. They went from whiny to shiny.
Wow.
So there we go with that.
Their hair's not black anymore. It's like
I love rock
brown.
And roll. Right, there you go.
Hair.
Is that rock and roll we're listening to? In the background there? So,
little Jesus and Mary Chain. They're not starting very quickly.
Wow.
No.
Is that
no.
them?
That's their new record?
A vegan version of a turducken.
Okay. No, man. This is not Jesus and the Mary Chain.
So let's get started.
This is Jesus.
They made the cake
Mary?
And the pie.
Stuffed inside
Where's the chain?
So fucking. The turkey,
which is probably the grossest
chain awesome.
I've ever heard.
I
eaten by simple
I think you should just keep doing the whole background shit because you've never been a part of the breaking news badly because it's bad. It's bad. JB will make it worse as he goes along. It's great.
So this is the music news or the world news?
No, just the whole breaking news badly. I'll give you another one here. First they jailed the bankers. Now every Icelander to get paid in bank sale. So this is from redicecreations.com, and this is an article. At first, Iceland jailed its crooked bankers for their direct involvement in the financial crisis of 2008. Now every Icelander will receive a payout for the sale of one of its three
Good
largest
for them.
Banks.
A payout.
Iceland Banky.
Good for
Iceland
them.
Bankily.
Is that the end of your second story?
That's like a third one.
They need to buy some something to keep them warm.
Wow, even in the same goddamn tone, bro.
That's like
wow, that is awesome.
That signifies the end.
Indeed. Joey. What's this weird audio you're playing right now, JB? This is your cue for your next lame story. Here we
it's
go.
It's just a video. If Chewbacca was played by Peter Griffin.
Okay. Right. You know what I love most about you, JB?
What?
Your stories.
Oh, yeah.
12 things you should never say to teachers. You go any guess?
Are you not going to go through all 12, are you?
Yeah, we'll go through the top.
That's a mighty long time. The worst thing you can say to your teacher, this is what I would think would be number one.
Okay. Teacher, I don't want to.
Did the condom break?
Okay, well,
I jumped up on my desk in science class when I was 13, and the lady, Mrs. Jefferson, was her name, and she was big and fat. And to be honest with you, she did.
I know,
like,
you ain't moving on up
to
that desk.
Look like Jabba the fucking Hutt.
Okay.
And,
wow.
And she was just like always picking on me. It seemed like always picking on me. So one day, I finally stood in front of like the beaker and all that shit, and I was screaming for like 2 minutes.
Screaming,
fuck you,
that.
Jabba! Fuck
what?
You, Jabba!
What?
And the whole class, you know, was encouraging, and so
wow.
Yeah, she hit my button. I got an in-school suspension.
Wow.
I bet you did.
So,
fuck
you, what,
Jabba,
respect
to
your teachers,
no,
though,
you
because it,
wow.
You know what? Look at it this way. It is all about having a good teacher and whatever you do. And in school, if you don't have a good teacher, then humor them. Let them get through the year so you can get through to
Let's
a
segue.
Good teacher to
Let,
something else.
Let's segue. So you're a guitar teacher.
Yeah,
actually.
What if I said, fuck you, Jabba, with your fucking stupid bass guitar,
we
fucker?
You also got to be a good
why
student.
Are you so
God.
Loud. Jerry, why are you so loud?
Well, I'm sorry.
You should never okay. save
that's
your
that's
teacher.
That's natural.
Yeah,
I
it is.
Cheated
ain't
on
no microphone
going
to fix that.
I've never told my teacher I cheated on my test.
Okay.
No,
just
your
I cheated on
respect.
My brother.
Teachers have a hard gig.
My sister.
They have a hard
lie.
Gig, and there's
Ooh,
good
this
teachers.
Is kind of mean. We've all been to elementary school, so aren't we all kind of experts on it? That's
yeah.
a pretty mean thing to say to an elementary
well,
school
Well, why
teacher.
Don't you try and do a fourth grader's
right.
math homework?
Right.
or history right. homework.
There you go.
Are you bringing up old shit again, Brian? Just kidding.
When I retire,
I don't even know what that means.
I still want to do something, so I think I might take up teaching. Have you ever thought about making your class more fun? So just a few examples there of what not to say to a teacher in case you ever meet a teacher.
Fuck you, Jabba is one.
yeah, and I love it. The hell is that?
We jamming? What are we jamming?
Yeah, JB, what is that?
The funniest thing today I've seen.
So loud, dude.
Oh, my God.
Funky town.
Funniest things I've seen today by Demick on Facebook. He mashed up all these sounds.
I'm going to pee.
It's great.
I'm going to okay. pee, everybody.
So there you go. All right, with all the audio we have, and I forgot we have a great guitarist actually in studio. Give us a little interlude, I guess, from the news, if you'd like, sir. Anything you choose.
What are we going into?
We're going to go into Sinead O'Connor threatened suicide in dire Facebook post.
Oh.
Nothing compares.
I hope Sinead gets it together.
It
was an interlude. Oh, this is on?
No, definitely. Hey,
I had no
Brian.
Idea that we were still on air.
I know, Brian. I was too. You know what? I was closing my eyes and I was listening to you playing guitar. And just like, it's timeless. It's. I think back of all like some different really cool shows that we have had in Orlando. I remember being at Lollapalooza or like some festivals. And
remember when those things wouldn't come to Florida?
Yeah,
you know now they do, and they well, they're it's
yeah.
getting better and better.
How about you know?
Yes.
Definitely things had like a break, and I believe
that,
it, and just feeling it within my own self with the salon and different avenues
yeah.
that are going on in the arts.
There's a lot of good opportunity. And that's good.
There's a real beautiful art music scene.
It's like we're all joined together, and I love it. I feel like it's a whole... People are coming back again.
Let's talk about the RollingStone.com. RollingStone.com. Sinead O'Connor threatens suicide in dire Facebook post November 29th, 2015. So
I got something to ask Brian.
What do you think about that?
I got something to ask Brian.
Oh, you got a question. Oh, before that.
Brian, before we get into that, I want to know about the Orlando Weekly and Slim Rider. Wasn't there some beef? I saw something going back and forth.
Are you guys
sorted out? Like, I would definitely say I was posting for you.
I'd rather not talk about, but it's a good example of how social media blows things
crazy,
out of proportion.
Right?
And, you know, like, ultimately, you know, that's something I'd rather not talk about.
Okay.
She's an amazing person.
I didn't know how that sort of...
An amazing person and an asset to the community, and I really have no problem. In fact, nothing but respect. Right. It was just something that was stupid that kind of got out of hand. And, you know, every now and again, you got to say sorry for my role in it. And it was, right. whatever it was, it's not worth talking about.
All right.
Going
so,
into.
On
it's
I got a question
good.
For you. So,
fantastic.
How old were you when your parents found out you were gay?
Okay.
Come on.
That's really.
You asked a tough question, Jerry.
What I really meant to ask him is
my wife.
Okay.
Yeah. How old were you when you learned how to rollerblade? Almost the same question, but only.
Did you drink Capri Suns as a kid?
And I know Brian doesn't rollerblade.
Have you ever drank a Capri Sun? That's a better question. Have you ever had a Capri Sun?
Wakeboarding. Friendship.
You've had a Capri Sun then.
All those things aren't really good for me. Rollerblading, roller skates.
Oh, rolling in general. Rolling. So I got a great question for Brian. You ready for this one? This is totally off the cuff. So Brian, I've been to your house many times. And
you're a good friend.
Yes, we definitely have a great friendship together. Every time that I come to your home,
remember when I called you out and I was like, "You're a dick."
I do.
I looked in your medicine cabinet.
But just earlier,
that was when we first met
moments ago.
And I'm glad you did that. Because it's the people that don't call you out and shit that don't really matter in your life.
Well, sometimes you gotta suffer your friends. That's a real important thing to do.
You do.
It's true.
You know, you get the benefits and you get the shits.
This is the best version of Breaking News Badly we've ever had with live guitar.
What's your next story?
This is great.
What's
no, I'm dead serious.
Hey, can you play guitar to the news?
Guitar, the news.
Play guitar.
He's been doing
that.
He's been doing that.
Have
you not been listening, Jelicious?
No, we got to have lyrics to it.
You should start listening.
The climate change debate.
Well, it's December 2nd, and it's fucking 80 degrees.
I think there's a climate change going on.
What do you guys think?
This climate has changed.
All the climates have changed. Whether it be...
It's getting cold in here.
Weather, professional, or personal, they're all changing. Everything is changing. That's why I voted for Obama. Obama.
What are you doing over there?
I'm voting for Obi-Wan for 2016. Right. He is our only hope.
He is our only hope. It's 2016.
That's for sure.
That's right. You excited about the Star Wars movie?
You know,
I am, but I'm not going to camp out or nothing.
How about you, Brian? Are you excited about the Star Wars movie? Have you ever gotten into the Star Wars thing?
Yeah, absolutely.
All right.
You know.
Are you going to see it in the theater?
Born in 73, man.
Are you looking forward to this next movie?
Yeah, I'm not going to be waiting in line or camping out or anything like that, but I'm definitely looking forward to it.
Are you going
to
see it in the theater, you think?
I'd like to.
You'd like to.
Wait, let me ask you this.
And let me ask everybody here in the room,
okay.
Jalicious included.
Uh-huh.
I mean, since all this turmoil and all the shootings and theaters, when's the last time any one of you has seen a movie in the movie theater?
It's been a long time. I don't go out.
When's the last time, Brian? You saw a movie.
I don't leave the house.
Every now and again, Britt and I go through phases where we go see a movie.
Listen to the question. When was the last time?
Within 6 months.
Okay. There you go.
All right. Do you remember the name of the movie?
Not a clue.
Okay, good.
Oh,
okay.
That was, I've seen you, Not JB? A Clue. That's a great mystery movie. I've seen that.
JB, how about you? When's the last time you were in the movie theater?
Boy, it must have been a superhero movie. It's probably Captain Avenger with my brother like 2 or 3 summers ago. So.
Okay, Jalicious. What's the last movie you saw?
I think it was that movie 2012 with John Cusack. And we had to leave the theater.
I don't even remember that.
My ex-husband was like, we're not watching this. It's terrible.
So how many years ago was that? Exactly my point.
Eight
and this
years
is why
ago,
I bring this up, you guys.
Ago.
You often don't see John and Joan Cusack in a room, leading me to believe that they could possibly potentially be the same person.
Oh,
what's happened?
Brian. So my point being, I cannot remember the last movie that I saw in the movie theater.
You need to get out more.
Okay.
No, I don't. I actually really like my house.
I got you.
And I got a great setup.
A great house.
Right.
Thanks, Brian.
I like your house.
That's what you did.
Jalicious will never be there.
That's because you're getting old. You're getting old. Get out of the house. Get out of the house, Reverend.
You ready? You ready for the next one?
Here we go.
You ready?
Let's do it.
Milk does not do a body good. Collective-evolution.com. Has an article. His new massive study says milk does not do a body good. You want to hear more about
do
that?
Do it.
You want to, oh, Arnold likes milk. Do you like milk? Arnold? No.
Come on.
You want more milk.
Yeah. So, do you like milk, Brian?
Yeah, I love milk.
You do?
Boys love milk. Boys love milk.
I like that look, Brian.
Girls
that,
love,
I
know, I wouldn't know. Boys that love milk.
Here's a 1990s anti-drug PSA.
I think I cut my finger.
What's this one?
I really do.
Statistics show that 40% of all
there
you go. Smoke marijuana live in the city.
It's really bad audio, by the way. And then
guess where the other 60% live?
Oh, official Office of National Drug Control Policy back in the 1990s. So anyway, I pulled that up. And I'm going to give you a couple more. Wait, I got so many more. I want to bring this topic, and I want to thank Mr. Ralph Verano for doing the fantastic show portrait of me that he did. I didn't see that.
That's I was Ralph. Like, when I saw it, I was like...
Yeah, you were like, that's exactly dead on. How did he do that?
It really is. It's your profile picture on your Facebook.
It's glorious, yeah.
And it really, he did that?
I want to thank him, Ralph Verano. Yeah.
Ralph Verano.
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 He is very... Ralph Verano. Is he local?
Samantha.
What? Yeah. Is he local?
Yes, he's local.
About,
yes.
Obviously.
Yes. All right.
Yeah,
cool.
He does a lot of great work. But I want to bring this up. It's analog artist digitalworld.com. It is our friend Thor. Thor Sprecken, right?
Thor Sprecken.
You understand who I'm speaking of?
Thor Sprecken.
Do it.
Is it?
Come on.
It's Thor Sprecken.
It's Thomas Thor Sprecken. Right?
Thomas Thor Sprecken.
Right. You know who I'm talking? He goes around and sketches.
No.
He does all these great sketches.
I don't, actually.
Anyway, he has this article. Go to analogartistdigitalworld.com. Check out this article. It's Kicked Out of Sam Flax, The Story of Otter and the Gun. So really great article there. I want to encourage people to go check that out. Because there's a whole comment thread there kind of related to the Orlando art culture and scene. And then I pulled up an old ad, and let me pop this up there, I guess. It's a daddy saddle. It was a real thing back 60s and 70s or something like that. But there you go, daddy saddle. It's now every child's favorite game. So it's a real little saddle you put on your dad's back and ride him like a horse.
Nice.
So,
ride a horse.
I thought that was important.
Sick,
right?
They sell
thought,
that these days, and they call it something else, and it's not on your
Brian
daddy
play
necessarily.
Again.
Yeah, well, it could be
or
your
maybe
daddy.
Maybe it is on
like
your
daddy. Sugar daddy. Another one from RollingStone.com, how LSD microdosing became the hot new business trip.
Oh.
A great new article.
Oh, now we're listening.
No, yeah, but...
Oh, now we're listening. Say what?
No. Have you heard about this?
I saw that. I love the idea.
Of course we're all listening.
I absolutely love it.
Like we've all heard it.
Right. So here's the article. Ken is one of the growing number of professionals who enjoy taking microdoses of psychedelics in his free time and occasionally at the office. I had an epic time, he says. At the end of one such day, I was making a lot of sales, talking to a lot of people, finding solutions to their technical problems. A microdose is about a tenth of the normal dose. Around, 10 micrograms of LSD.
Supposedly, you just are happy, you have a good day.
Point two.
And
Yeah, 0.2 to 0.5 grams of mushrooms. The dose is sub-perceptual enough, says Rick Doblin, founder and executive director of Multidisciplinary Association of Psychedelic Studies. So RollingStone.com, again, has that study, has that article.
That's a great story,
and how LSD microdosing became the new business trip.
Interesting,
can we,
right?
Can we hear any of that?
No. You said psychedelic.
Oh, he was off. He was off.
That's a little loud. Turn it down a little bit. There we go. A little bit.
You said psychedelic. It made me think of Pink Floyd Interstellar Overdrive.
Oh,
oh no,
dude.
You, when you play, like, I can definitely, like, close my eyes. And
turn it down just a little bit.
Oh,
my God.
Hey, is that your new board, by the way?
It's not even a new board. The other one is straight up just studio recording. So that's a studio recording. Yeah, yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
www.cbc.ca has an article here. Costco apologizes for labeling Bible as fiction. So apparently they had put the Bible in the fiction category at the Costco. Somebody was gangbanging on that.
Of course,
but
amazed man.
I contend if you have faith, you don't even need to worry about that shit, right? Isn't that what faith is all about? I could be mistaken.
No, maybe.
I don't know how words work, but
faith has got a lot of restrictions.
A lot of restrictions? Restrictions on faith.
Got a lot of religious restrictions.
Right. Let's talk about it then.
Let's talk about that.
Everybody does.
I got something to talk about when you're done with this breaking
Let's
news
go.
Badly.
No, you got, throw something
Brian
in there, buddy.
Play.
Is that what you're talking
about? No. I'm going to do a little something with Brian to close this show out. But once you're done, we're done with the whole breaking news badly, I know Brian's going to be excited about this because I can tell by looking at him right now.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Nobody knows what you're talking about.
I really
we're all flying by the seat of your pants.
Yeah. Well, we got more breaking news badly, do we not?
I have plenty more stories. Yes, sir. Yes,
well,
sir.
Let's see what you got because at the end, I'm thinking Brian's just going to go into this like bluesy cool riff.
Did you know that there are over 5 languages in this world? We don't need all these languages, people. We don't need
What we don't need is silent
British
letters.
Language,
Chili Palmer.
Canadian language or Brilliant Hawaiian concept. Language or Alaskan language. We need just American, okay? Just American language. Nothing more, nothing less, just American. You wanna know why? Because the letters are pretty. They're cute, pretty letters. Like you can't get letters.
Uh-huh, like, yeah. So Chili Palmer puts these videos together where he looks at someone who's saying something like this girl, and he just looks at her. It's brilliant.
Right.
Chili Palmer 69.
Chili
69 Palmer.
Like a Letterman skit to ask current events or something on the streets of L.A., New York.
Sorry.
So that was actually good, I think. That girl was ridiculous. That girl was ridiculous, wasn't she?
You want to talk about ridiculous.
Yeah, we've been a comedy rock band for close to 40 years now. And all that time, we've never had a hit.
But you guys know why.
Why?
Because we never wrote a 4-chord song.
What's a 4-chord song, Benny?
Well, if you want all the greatest hits from the past 40 years, just use 4 chords. Same 4 chords for every song. It's dead simple to write a pop hit.
Just 4?
Yeah, these 4. Hit. 1,
you're
2,
not gonna play all this,
3,
right?
4 chords.
Sorry, let me get this straight, Chicken Little. What you're trying to say is you can take those 4 chords, repeat them, and pump out every pop song ever. Is that what you're saying?
Is that what he's saying? Is that true? We've got a musical.
It absolutely is true.
Okay,
keep playing.
It's a brilliant example of how music is, it's like, you ever see those restaurant menus that are gigantic and there's 4 things in the kitchen?
Right.
Yes.
There it is.
It's like going to Mexico and you know, whether it's a taco, a burrito, an enchilada, a chimichanga. It's all basically
Who's popping? Who's cracking?
Meat and vegetables and rice wrapped
in a tortilla. There you go. Okay. You were crackling. Who's crackling? Now there's no crackle. Is he there?
I don't know. I'm not here.
You're not there. Wait.
I'm no longer here.
Wait, you're there. All right. Is he there?
Maybe it's a sign.
I think he's
there. He's there. He's over there.
Okay.
I'm here.
I'm so sorry. All right.
I'm queer. Get used to it.
Okay, I'm used to it. I'm totally.
So
Oh, I don't have my board. Ah, I went to hit seriously.
Seriously.
So you got to say it for me. What else you got? A programmer who wrote scripts to secretly automate a lot of his job and email his wife makes a latte. So this is businessinsider.com as an article about this guy who basically wrote automated his job. I think that's fucking brilliant.
It's fucking brilliant.
Yeah, I'm going right into the next one. Atlanta.cbslocal.com. Teens create smart condoms that glow in the dark to indicate if person has STD. You see this?
What? No.
So
that would be embarrassing.
That would be, wouldn't it?
A swingers party.
Yeah, you're like, hey, yeah. Everybody.
His condom's the wrong color.
Here comes old green dick.
I'm not sucking that dick. God,
watch out for green dick over there.
Seriously.
Oh, device is missing. What are you talking about?
I'm for sure not going to suck on that.
Okay.
Jill's already all over it. Oh, my God.
Okay, wait. People who...
Nothing from you, Jill? Come on. Bring it.
I'll give it a try.
Okay.
Is she up?
Are you up?
Right, so we're going to finish up with this breaking news battery.
Right. Okay. And then you want to go into the after show?
No, I want to hear Brian play another.
What do you want to do? Hold on. Let's have a consensus.
Time.
All right, so we're going to cut away with a little.
No, we don't have to cut anywhere.
Electric rodeo.
Our guest is going to.
Why are you still crackling?
I'm crackling up.
He's crackling up.
That's why.
So I can't emphasize enough how excited I am that Brian's been in studio with us all this time.
And what about Jalicious?
Jalicious, there's no doubt that I'm not excited that you're here because the banter back and forth between us, whether it's good or bad, is still awesome and entertaining as hell. And you got great questions. The only thing that I have with you, Jill, I'll go ahead and talk to you live on air about this, is sometimes you bring the, like you did it tonight, you do it every time, you bring up, like you bring the drama, which is good sometimes, but sometimes it's bad. And by drama, I mean like, you know, like, you brought up, I go deep. You go sometimes a little too deep.
We're
trying to keep it, you know, a little up.
Light.
And no. But you know what? It's real.
You're bringing
Orlando.
Up hot button issues.
But you know what?
I grew up in Orlando, and we all have respect for that. It's never in any disrespect.
Okay, we know the true Orlando spirit.
Let me finish.
It's our roots. Quite honestly, it's our roots.
But let me finish.
Who made us?
Okay, listen. Let me finish. I appreciate that. But sometimes these hot buttons are a little too hot, and we don't want to make...
Maybe for you, Jerry.
No. For everyone involved, Jill. Sometimes we just want to, you know, we want to keep it up, and they are... hear me out. Don't make me turn your mic down. I want you to hear me, because this is important, Jill. Look at me, too, when I'm talking to you, because this is important, because you are a very independent alpha female, and I appreciate that very much, and I would love you being part of this. There's no doubt. No. But at times we should precurse some of these questions at times because it just brings it down. Like for instance, you know, tonight Brian didn't want to answer a question that you brought up, and you know, and maybe you know, which is fine.
Why are you doing it now?
Because it's important to make this successful.
Where's Dr. Phil?
It's all about the drama.
Dr. Phil's gonna jump in here in a minute, and he's gonna say, Jerry.
Hey.
Hey, Jill, what is your problem?
No, it's not.
Why are you doing that to the guests?
I think you need to calm it down. What's going to happen? All right, let's bust
and
away.
Jerry, what do you have this problem with Jill?
Let's bust away.
We need to just chill out.
Yeah, we do. Hold on. Listen to this. We'll be right back.
Thank you. You don't want this.
The electronics are so predominant that people would really prefer that.
Oh, my goodness. Welcome back. We have a special in-studio treat. Mr. Chodorcoff's going to serenade us a little bit. What do we want to do with the time?
I just want to hear Brian after-show end it mode. Out with a sweet tune, because that was amazing.
Well, let's give
before.
Him the mic, or let's give him the guitar, as it were. What's important to you? You know, I mean, you've known Brian probably longer than any of us, right? Easily said.
Yeah.
You guys kind of came up, grew up, right?
Yeah.
And so, Jerry, what's your prescription? What's your...
All right.
How many Hail Marys do I got to do?
Thanks for giving me the floor for that for a second. Because, you know, I have known Brian for several decades. And Brian is very true to himself. And he's very true to the scene. And to basically sharing love, as long as I've known him, there's no mystery with Brian. He's like right up in your face, and if you're not doing, you know, something right, whether he's teaching you the way he plays music or teaching his students, he's just a natural born teacher. And he's taught me a lot in my personal life.
Well, that's a good point.
Yeah.
So if somebody wants to learn under you, Brian, what's the best way? Is there a good email address out there? Yeah, what's the best way for them to connect with you about that?
Bison34@yahoo is my email address. And you can call me at 407-733-3033, and I'm not scared to give that number out because I've already had an insane experience.
Well, let's hear this story.
You want to hear this story?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, you're a great storyteller.
I got married to my beautiful wife in
Brittany.
June.
And Brittany, I'm sorry I called you Kristen because, like, you're Brittany. Sorry, Brittany.
A couple months later, I get this phone call, and she's not with me, and it's this guy telling me this horrible story about Brit's in an accident, uses her name, found stuff online to make it real personal, and I was about to get into a rehearsal.
Yeah, this is
horrible. I'm supposed to go get money and drop it off at a fucking Walmart or something. It's one of those scams. And they, you know what? I was the Eskimo buying ice for that moment, because what they do is go through 1,000 people to get two. Jeez. Old lady will drop off $20,000 in a garbage can at Walmart, and it's worth 1,000 phone calls to get that.
Right.
And they get little bits and they get big bits, and it happens all the time, particularly to old people and kids who, they tell you they find stuff online. You know, they found her accident report and they made it real personal. And I was in this insane panic, you know. They're telling me that, you know, they're going to...
Okay,
they
saying
got my
it was
wife.
Based off of a real accident report that they found out. She was a fender bender, but they turned it into cataclysmic kind of a thing? Is that what happened?
They told me... they called me and they said, is this Brian Chodorcoff? I said, yeah. They said, your wife's been in a terrible accident.
Oh, my God.
And I'm an EMT. And she's bleeding from her head, and she's going to be okay. And he sounded like an EMT for about 30 seconds, and then his tone changed, and he said, listen, motherfucker, your wife hit my son, and his bike and his leg are fucked up, and I want money because I got no fucking insurance, and I will kill your fucking wife. They went as far to act it out. I you know, I'm like...
A girl screaming in the background.
Yeah, they had somebody in the... Like, at one point during this, it was long, but, like, for you know, 7-8 minutes of my life, I believed that my...
Oh, my God.
You know, my life was in this situation. And now here's the thing. The only reason we're telling this story is because it happens. Everybody has a story that happened to somebody or somebody they know or themselves. And they're real common.
Keep going, Brian.
No, they're real common. And when I talked to the cop had all this information. The funny thing is, it happened again 2 weeks after that when the guy called, and he goes, "Is this?" And I could tell just for some reason by the voice, you know. And he's like, "You know, your wife's been in an accident." And I just hung up on him, you know.
You should have been
same
like,
token,
you know what?
For those few seconds when you believe it, you know, it's a pretty awful place. So I'd rather, you know, fuck up than. lose a couple bucks, that's nothing, you know. Wow. But it's sad because a lot of people don't
fall
throw
for this.
A lot of money. Yep. Yep, and it's a big deal. Mm. And
you know what's even crazier? It's the same fucking number, and I don't understand why they don't shut
numbers.
That.
Well, they can hijack numbers. I looked into it. You know, I was going to do something on the news and then realize it's kind of... I don't want, you know, these guys already know where I live.
Well, just getting it out there now. Right.
But it is getting it out there so people don't fall for it.
They switch numbers around.
It's awful. They steal people's numbers, and it's just like anything. It's cyber crimes, you know? And then basically, look at it this way. It's like same thing as a timeshare sales office where there's a row, four rows of 10 people each, and a guy walking around pointing to the rebuttals and the shit like that, but this is for
scandals. It's a phone room, for sure.
And so it's a modern, you know, it's a cyber gang, for sure. You know, my thought is like these guys with, you know, mohawks and tattoos sitting around, you know, on a computer hustling people, you know, the good old days, they just, you know, stuck a knife in your face or something, I guess.
So, Brian, I like how you turn this whole thing around about me giving you praise about how awesome you are. And then you start talking about the story, which is bringing, like, you know, I don't even know what I'm saying anymore. You know what I'm saying?
Well, we've been friends a long time, Jerry.
No, dude.
And everybody in this room, I've known you guys for years. Just sometimes you don't know.
I'm just glad. We're glad you're here.
Yeah, tonight, like, man. The story back where, it was a... Yeah, and the coolest thing in the world was the Orlando scene back in the day. It was great for music.
Still.
No, but I'm just
saying. It's better today.
It's amazing.
When you reminisce and you were there and you're like, wow, look where we are now. Beautiful. There's a lot of great stuff out there now. Woolly Bushman, I like them. We played Last Electric Rodeo. We have Pilot Wave. There's a Bear Toe out of DeLand. There's there's a lot of great stuff out there. And Orlando's got it.
Always has been.
A ton of bands out there that are absolutely amazing. Orlando is a brilliant music scene that is to a degree a secret, and to a degree, part of me is real happy about that. You know,
right? Keeps
it's so great, Brian, and thank you so much. That it's nice to know that people from the back in the day that has that soul from Orlando is still here with us today and seeing the change.
Wow,
and we really appreciate you so much. And we're looking forward to the Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah. December 18th, Will's Pub.
Definitely. Bring food, canned food.
It's going to be awesome.
Absolutely. And once again, that's going to be benefiting Brian.
The Fern Creek Elementary School Food Pantry Program. Don't worry, we're working on something. We have something called 1 in 4 Strike right. Against Hunger because my wife did it on a Campbell's soup, can like Warhol,
Warhol.
And it says 1 in 4 because that's the ratio of kids that are missing meals completely when they're not at school.
The
school will give them breakfast and lunch, and
one out of four
doesn't get dinner. So, you know, 1 in 4 Strike Against Hunger.
Wow,
is the idea. And anything that I do these days, my real dream is that it picks up into other bars. The initial idea being, you know, you bring me a can of food for these kids, I'll give you a beer.
Right, right.
And to a lot of bar owners, that's nothing. That ain't shit.
Definitely not.
You know, you got to give back.
That can of corn might save some kid's life for real.
If you can
or
the
give
kid,
them the nutrition they need, you know, to grow up.
It's horrible.
The right way.
It's right down the street. It's in our neighborhood.
It is.
So.
It's in our
glorious.
Face.
Well, I'd love to see that explode.
Let's help our neighborhood. It's our hood.
Yeah, exactly. I'd love to see it explode, and I think it should. And let's give a big round of applause for Brian. I appreciate you.
Thank you, Brian.
I think we'll play a couple of tracks. You rock, brother. You have so much to offer the community. You've already done so much great work. And again, man, we appreciate you coming in here and laid it down. And I appreciate the live guitar. Anytime you want to create a track, let's just let him play.
Yeah. I would love to.
What do you want to do? Do you want to play us out of here, or what do you want to do?
No, I'm good. I'm sorry. Play something out, actually.
Okay. Okay. Well, I got a couple things here from Mr. Polka Dot Logic, a.k.a. Anthony Cole. And,
oh, wait, I do have one thing I'd love to
Push
out.
Yeah.
Myself, Thomas Wynn, and Anthony Cole have a project called ATB.
I haven't heard of this.
Yes. ATB. We're playing, just really it's three old friends that get together and play gigs when it's possible to. But some of the material we're playing is stuff that I've written and recorded with Anthony in the past.
Okay.
And if you go to Brian Chodorcoff at Reverb Nation or SoundCloud, you can hear some of the stuff that we're doing. Really, that band, goals other than having fun with each other and playing some music, making a glorious couple bucks.
Definitely making a difference. Orlando legend.
So, let me say something.
Brian, thank you so much for being here.
ATB, I saw, I had the opportunity to see them at Space Bar, and it was amazing. And, dude, great show. It's been awesome. Thank you so much for being here, Brian.
Thank you guys for having me. This is an amazing environment.
We appreciate you, brother. Thank you for coming in. I really do.
What are you closing out with?
We want to do as much in studio. We got a couple tracks. I'm going to play a little Evan Teller Jones right after Polka Dot Logic, a.k.a. Peak Level Indicator, a.k.a. Anthony Cole, kind of side project here. So, but this is a rendition of Understand that's a little bit grittier. So enjoy this. We'll come back with a little After Hours if we're going to do that or not. I don't know. But see you on the flip-flop. Thanks for listening to us. WJBWnetworks.com is the primary site. And we'll be after showing it here. Hold on. See ya.
I know I'm making noise. together. Yes, indeed. Lord, have mercy on us.
Closer to where we wanna be. Closer. Orlando, Florida. The first quasi-radio web show.
Wow. Yeah.
All right. So this is a little after hours with the JB Webb Show. This is me, Jerry, the Reverend. I'm here with JB Webb. And Brian Chodorcoff is still here in the studio
with us.
Yeah,
it's hard to leave, man.
Pretty big deal. Brian, I can't thank you enough for coming out here tonight. Wow. It's a pretty big deal. You know, there's a lot we didn't cover in the first segment, and mainly the influence that you've had in this town has been incredible. It's the countless bands that you've been in since you've been here. I mean, you have absolutely made your mark in Orlando.
I'm really lucky, also, man. There's a lot of great people and all sorts of music and places that have had me on their recordings or their stage.
What's the name of the recent stuff you said?
ATB.
A-T-B.
Which means Anthony.
Cole, Thomas Wynn.
Okay, cool. All right, I'm going to look some of that up. Hold on.
Anthony, Thomas, Brian.
There's some videos on my Facebook page or something, like if you go scrolling down long enough. But, you know, that's we're not pushing that as anything. We're just having fun with that.
Exactly.
That's just some friends doing what friends do.
But in the same sense,
for friends.
You
at a place owned by friends.
Exclusively while watching Friends on syndicated television.
But by you guys doing that, you are providing this opportunity for people like myself and, you know, everyone involved in the Orlando scene to see you. I mean, I remember seeing you at Space Bar a couple months ago and telling you that I've seen thousands of concerts in my lifetime, but that show in particular at Space Bar was in my top 10 because just the way that you guys melded together, I had never seen that live. Let me finish, Brian.
Oh my God, now he's stopping you.
No, but it was a pretty big, I mean, in my top 10 concerts, come on.
I've, like, great.
I said, thousands of concerts that I've seen. And do you remember me telling you that night?
I do.
Okay, because, I mean, that was a big deal. Just the way you guys, I mean, it was like the three of you were married. You were all one. So there we go.
You know, it's
it was amazing, Brian. Amazing.
Thank you, Jerry. It's really three friends who are really just, it's an opportunity to play. And jokes aside, that's exactly what it is. Friends that play with friends, for friends, at friends' places. So
right.
I do appreciate that. You know, there's so many things. Those guys are so brilliant. And really, everybody that a long time ago, I really got into teaching so that I didn't have to do certain gigs to pay the bills because I certainly didn't want to go get another job. And so there's so many bands that I get to play with and so many different things, and it's really an honor to be a part of so many different things and brilliant people. But I guess the point of my story is that I get to sort of say yes and no to things. I don't rely on some of it for, for its crazy income. I rely on it for the soul. The camaraderie, the way that it is, the music, you know, that's really what it's about. So, fortunately, some of it does pay well, and the stuff that doesn't is equally as beautiful.
And you're still the whole time doing what you love, and you express it through not only your students that you're teaching, but your friends and your fans that are listening to you. I mean, it's a heavy connection that it goes deep, and it what you do is, I mean, it's amazing, Brian, and I can't thank you enough.
Made me blush tonight. I feel like really, really blessed and overwhelmed at the kindness, and I appreciate it. I really am kind of humble and feel very lucky to be here, honored to be here.
Me as well, Brian. I got to tell you, I mean, like I feel. Just by being in the same room with you, blessed, and in every aspect of my life, whether it be through being, you know, with Dana, my beautiful wife, and knowing you and Brittany and, like, you know, Terry. Man,
our friendship,
the list,
for
like,
sure,
dude, I mean, it's like, it's, it goes on and
Kevin
on.
Kevin Bacon, how you're connected to him through 6 degrees.
It's only like 2 degrees.
Making me feel like Kevin Bacon.
I like, yeah, you are Kevin. Doesn't he play in a band with his brother?
He does.
Kevin Bacon Band or the whatever, yeah. Bacon Band?
They're called the Bacon Band.
I like the bacon, they're bacon delicious.
They are delicious if you
one of them's a turkey, though, turkey bacon. It's not as good. Yeah, man, I'll tell you what, like I said, with all of those memories, the seeing the young guy, what's his name, Machado?
Marcus Machado.
Marcus Machado, seeing him that at Will's Lock Haven pub, you were there. And Ryman Connection House Party, you were there, kind of a thing. You know, it's like I don't have that deep, long connection, but again, that's a testament to what Orlando is. It's like this guy was, you know, there kind of peripherally, and even though, you know, I've never had the long, extended time with you, I already knew that you're a fantastic guy. And the heart of you is what's important that we transmit out there, that the heart of you is pure and your motives are pure. So that's why I'm like, man, let's do it and venerate it. And that's why we can't talk enough about December 18th, Will's Pub.
Absolutely.
Bring cans. Bring your cans and your cans. And your cans, if you can.
For reals.
And go there December 18th. How much tickets on sale?
Is there a door discount? I believe it's 12 discount at the door.
Oh, that's pretty righteous.
You know,
righteous
price. Come up and
get
whatever you got. Come in.
Yep.
I'm sure it'll sell out. Are tickets being sold at Park Avenue CDs?
I really don't know. I imagine so.
You're putting them on the spot, Jerry.
Wills does a lot
spotlight.
Of that. If not, you know, it's going to start early and go late. So
I can only imagine that show will sell out for sure.
I would hope so.
Well, we hope so.
Because the cause and the lineup
absolutely.
Is nuts. I'm really excited. The lineup is, it's always nuts. And everybody it brings their A game to this Christmas party. And it's a blast to, you know, again, that's the cans of food and getting the friends in the same place are the secret reasons to honor Jimmy. But Jimmy, you know, this should be
have
said
you
that the reason this event exists is because the brilliance and the influence giving a lot of us an opportunity to explore sound and our instrument to make a living with our instrument, and that comes directly from a cat like that. We do tribute sometime, and they're a little bit lighthearted, and then sometimes we do them, and they're pretty deep, and this is one of those. And not that the lighthearted isn't, you know, I play those all the time, but this is something where it's a little heavy. So
it's an awesome cause, and you've been doing this for
hell yeah. And at the we'll wrap all of this up. I have a remix of Purple Haze done by a buddy of mine, Uniform, DJ Uniform. So we'll do that at the end.
Perfect.
But I think what's cool again is that you keep going. Now I didn't know about the Bob Dylan thing. What tell us a little about that? Is that something that kind of started recently?
Know,
isn't Bob Dylan still alive?
Oh,
am
yeah.
I an idiot?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
His influence.
Okay. Oh, okay.
Also,
that's,
you know,
fantastic.
The Beatles, you asked Jimi Hendrix and the Beatles who their favorite musician is. It's Dylan. And a long time ago, I got pretty into Dylan. But, you know, more importantly, that came about as the guys, Ron and Josh, good friends who own the Smiling Bison. I you know, drunkenly one night said, man, what are you wanting here? What, you know, if you could have a band up there and without
the best food and the best vibe
there. Yeah, they
do.
Yeah.
Unsolicited plug number three.
Yeah, and they you know, they hang Brit's art in there. It's all, you know, again, for sale and stuff. And they and so Josh said, you know, let's do Dylan. And I got some friends to play Dylan, and it was so good that we did it a second time. And now, you know, he already said, let's do it again. And it is because of his influence.
Oh,
and
they do that again,
you
Bob.
Know, hell it yeah. is. It is how you know. I feel really lucky to be part of. I'm gonna wait, man. Tributes like to Dylan and Hendrix, because they really do a lot for us.
Yeah. Well, I think, you know, even to venerate somebody like that and say these are major influences, these are people that are important, that's up to us to do now, you know, because everybody has their own voice, and it gets watered down of how, oh, look at my selfie, and here I am in front of the Disney swan with a, you know, a cucumber popsicle. I don't even know. I hope it is a cucumber.
Quote, Big Jeff
I hope it's
special.
Not that green STD guy from the news. But anyway, point being,
that's JB getting carried away.
I'm trying to wrap it into a nice little
You know, I'll quote Big Jeff Special.
Hey, look, I got my
say,
own fail button.
Wait. Oh, sorry. I will quote Big Jeff Special when I say, I just want to be making music with my friends.
There you go.
Unquote.
And you know what?
Oh, yes.
Oh, yes.
That you have been doing for sure.
Yeah, that's Brian. Where it's at.
And we can't thank you enough, Brian. This has been a great episode. And thanks again for being, you know, not only a part of the scene, but actually enhancing the scene by being involved with, like, not only the bands that are, like, you know, on top of the, you know, the broth, but the bands on the bottom too. I mean, you don't discriminate. You are really,
he's out for the music. He's out for the music authentically. Yeah,
exactly.
So we appreciate you again coming in studio. We're speaking with the one and only. He hung with us through the whole damn thing. It's awesome. Very respectable. Gosh darn it.
Let's talk about where we're going next, which is Little Indies.
Oh, let's talk about our star. We haven't spoken about Little Indies. Now you guys are going right out there.
Yeah,
what's going on out there? Tell us what's going on tonight at Little Indies.
I forget his last name, but Bjorn is a new friend. He's really talented. He opened up to Taylor the other night with an acoustic guitar, and is a great dude. Got to know him a little bit this last past weekend. So, yeah, we're going to go up and watch him play.
Nice. Awesome. And next door at Will's Pub is DJ BMF.
They're closed tonight, actually.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah, they're
doing
tonight. Some renovations there, buddy.
It's closed. Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
Breaking news badly.
All right.
The Reverend.
All right.
Thank you.
All right.
Thanks, fellas.
All right, rock the house. We appreciate you hanging out with us. WJBWnetworks.com is our primary site. Follow us there. Follow us here. Follow us everywhere we are, because we are everywhere. And we thank you for your support and listening. If you'd like to donate your original music, we can take it. Original music submission at WJBWnetworks.com. That's an email address. You can send us an MP3 or us to a safe download site. We'll play your stuff. We'll put it into steady rotation on the Circadian Cast, our two current productions ongoing. Anyway, once again, we thank you so much. We'll see you the next time.
WJBW Orlando, the very first quasi-radio web show.